We're going to begin with Sylvia, first of all. And Sylvia, you've got a bit of a problem with your son.
Morning.
Hello, Sylvia.
Morning.
Hello.
Hello, Sylvia, you there?
Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, we can. You
have a problem with your son you want to talk to Deirdre about.
Yes, that's correct.
Off you go.
My son is in his 30s and he keeps getting himself into a lot of debt. Now, I don't know whether it's the debt that's getting him depressed or the depression that's getting him into debt.
Right.
We do keep helping him out and we have helped him out on numerous occasions. We don't know where to go. He's at a depressed state at the moment and we don't know what to do next.
It's a vicious circle, really.
And is he
Sylvia?
Back spending?
Yes, he is.
What, in a big way, in an alarming way?
Big enough.
Yeah, OK.
Because he still has debts.
Right, OK. I think it's one of those stages where you're going to have to be firm about this. I mean, he's in his 30s. He is an adult. And overspending, being a spendaholic, can sometimes be about trying to, like, show you've still got some power and control in your life, while being depressed, of course, makes you feel as though your life is out of control and you can't really sort it out. So it's a sort of a very, very dangerous elastoplast over his feelings. And actually, I know it's really hard. You've already sorted him out clearly several times. I think this is the stage where you have to say, you know, we just can't keep doing this for you, because if nothing else, this is obviously not the right way to handle it, because you keep getting back into debt again. So give him that. There's National Debt Line. They're on our website. I'm happy to come and talk to you more after this about it. But I think this really is the point. You have to draw the line and you say, you are grown up now. You're going to have to sort out these debts for yourself. Take responsibility for your own decisions, because in a way that may actually make him start to feel more back in control of his life and therefore less depressed. Is he on medication for his depression?
No.
No. Well, get him to check with the doctor, but also try to get him to look at self-help ways of dealing with depression, like get him out doing some exercise. Get him looking for jobs, you know, because he's not working at the moment, is he?
No, he is working. And to be honest, he's been doing a lot of running.
Oh, good.
And all of a sudden, this running has stopped. And this is where the depression and the spending's come back into it.
OK, yeah. Well, so do you, the reinforcement you ought to be giving him is to get back into doing the running, get back into feeling in charge of his life that week, and make him, as I say, face up to responsibility for his own spending, and that he'll have to sort it out. As I say, there's National Debt Line, they're really good, so there is the help there.
Yeah, and
you Deirdre stop was, being the fallback.
Deirdre can talk to you as well off air, because I know it's so easy just to want to pay the debts for him and help him, because
he's
your son.
Of course it is, as a parent.
Sylvia, thank you. I've got to move on because we've got a lot of other people who have been in touch.